Today I'm going to be explaining everything that you need to know about DaVinci Resolve Stabilizer as quickly as possible. So if you are a filmmaker that is looking to get smooth footage, this video is for you. And to save you time, I've put together a free one-page cheat sheet that you can reference at a glance to know all of these settings for Resolve Stabilization, and that is going to be even faster for you than watching this quick video. So I will link that free cheat sheet down below. Now let's say that you have a clip that you're editing that is shaky and you want to stabilize it in Resolve. Like this clip that I have here that had a bit of shakiness due to my gimbal being a little overly sensitive. To do that, you can select your clip, go over here to the inspector and then down to stabilization and click stabilize, and Resolve is going to do its thing and hopefully stabilize your footage. But if that stabilization does not work for some reason, let's say you're seeing some wobbly jello effect like you can see right there in this clip, or maybe the motion blur looks weird or your video gets cropped in, I'm so happy to tell you that you have other options to help stabilize your footage and remove those issues. To start with this first drop down menu here, you're going to see that by default Resolve is going to use perspective, which basically means that it is analyzing your camera's pan, tilt, roll, and zoom to figure out how to stabilize the image. This usually works really well out of the box, but sometimes this can introduce unwanted jello or other wobbly effects in your shot. If that happens, you have two other options here. You could alternatively select Similarity and then hit Stabilize again, and Similarity is going to analyze those exact same things as Perspective, but use a different stabilization algorithm to do it, which can result in significantly better stabilization depending on what you're filming. This would be my first recommendation if your footage is not looking so good. Simply try Similarity and there's a chance for your footage to look a lot better. If your footage still doesn't look good, and especially if you're filming something on a gimbal, like say a barn that is a wedding venue, for example, when there isn't a subject in your shot and the barn itself is your subject, in this case, the translation option may be the best choice for you because it can help remove subtle camera shake. Let's hit stabilize and voila. Look how much smoother this shot is with translation. Moving on back to our first clip that still is being a little stubborn when it comes to stabilization, you're going to see a checkbox underneath the mode that says camera lock. And by default, this is going to be unchecked. If you are filming something handheld and you want to make it look like it was filmed on a tripod, this is the box that you want to check because it's essentially going to try to lock your image in place. Of course, keep in mind that if things look weird, you can go back up to mode and choose perspective, similarity, or translation with this checkbox, which may give you a better result. So don't be afraid to try that. Below the camera lock box, you have the zoom checkbox. And this is definitely a box that you're going to want to have checked because whenever you stabilize your footage in Resolve, it's going to zoom in a bit to help with stabilization. If you want to modify how much it's zooming in and out, you can use this cropping ratio slider, which by default is going to be set to 0.5. Increase the slider to 1.0 and Resolve is going to barely crop in on your footage and stabilize it less, or decrease the cropping ratio down to 0.25 and Resolve is going to crop in more, but also stabilize your footage more as well. You normally shouldn't need to mess with this setting, but if you're noticing that your footage is zooming in too much, try increasing the cropping ratio a bit more, and that can help smooth things out. Two settings left, you have smooth and strength. Smooth is, as the name implies, going to make your video smoother, and by default, it is set to the lowest setting, which usually should make your footage look smooth without overdoing it. But if you have a particularly shaky clip and you're trying to tame it, feel free to increase the smoothness, but be aware that if you do, Resolve is going to crop in on your image even tighter. You can get rid of some of that crop by increasing the cropping ratio, but that is going to offset some of the smoothing effect. It's all a balance, and the amount of smoothing versus ratio that you choose is really going to depend on the clip that you're stabilizing. Lastly, you have strength, and strength is really there to help with micro jitters that you would commonly see if you're filming with a camera handheld. By default, strength is going to be set to its full strength, as it were. But if you're noticing any subtle jello or warping effects, especially in the upper corners of your footage, decreasing this slider down to 0.5 or even 0 can help with that. For this clip, I find that choosing the similarity mode and setting the crop ratio to about 0.8 or so has really tamed some of the jello and warping and made this clip look great. And that is DaVinci Resolve Stabilizer Explained. Remember that you can download my free stabilizer cheat sheet down below. And if you want even more help with your video editing, I've created a free guide called Edit Videos Like a Pro. This guide is going to walk you through some of the biggest secrets that I have discovered over the years that will help you speed up your editing. You can download this guide completely for free at the link down below. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.